I enter my vehicle, I drove straight to Ashafa's office. And when I got to the office, I met Ashafa. So when I spoke with Ashafa, Ashafa said, oh, thank God that you are here. He thought it was a ghost that owned the house. He said, okay, just come to the board meeting. He said I should come to the board meeting. I stepped into the board meeting. I addressed everybody. So when I finished addressing them, Ashafa now told me that. He said, Kpokpogiri, please go to FCDA the same way you came to us. He said, I myself, Mr. Ashafa, I will discuss with FCDA, then we get back to you.
Right.
And that was on Thursday evening. So when I went back home, on Friday is Monday. These people, all these FCDA people, don't even come to work on Saturday. Yeah, or gas. Yeah. So I just have it in mind that, okay, by Monday, I will go to FCDA with my lawyer. You know, on Saturday was when they came to demolish. If there's no ulterior motive, why must it be on Saturday morning? Because I'm from the South.
Ashafa told you basically that I tried to call Ming Ashafa, his phone was switched up. I called him about 6 times. He told you basically that there was nothing to worry about and that you were not affected. And first thing on Monday, okay, they now showed up 14th of May, Saturday, and they started demolishing your house. I understand that your daughter was there, visitors were in the house. Did they not jeopardize public safety by doing that?
They were ready to kill anybody, everybody inside the house. They almost killed my staff because they just went straight to the wastewater, was pulling, eating, dead. They have to rescue the girl from the wastewater.
Hey! They didn't ask if anybody was in the house, they just attacked.
I'm telling you, even the maid unit, if not that some of the Niger Delta boys that were there said, if you people want to kill us, kill all of us. How can you just come? You are demolishing some of this property without asking to pick anything from the earth. He said, no, this can never happen.
That is what I wanted to ask you now, because the images I saw, I called a few people in Abuja and I said, I have to reach this guy. The images I saw were some young men who were taking your property out of the house and they were putting it, gathering it in one spot. I thought maybe they were looting, but I got angry because I said, they're not even open this house so that people can loot. Then I realized that they were actually helping you. So those were the Niger Delta boys, right?
Yes, some of the Niger Delta boys and some of all these outside boys that were working in some of these. They came together and they were pulling things from the paddock. They didn't even allow them. The man that led them there, he said, I give you people 30 minutes. 30 minutes. And immediately after 30 minutes, he ordered the bulldozer to stop bulldozing the main house. And I told him, and I woke up to him. I said, Oga, this thing that you are doing, if I were to be your brother, will you behave like this? Or is it because I'm from the South out? He said, then go back to your place. That's what he said.
That's what he said.
Yes.
Prince Kpokpogiri, I want to tell you that God will restore all that you've lost. Amen. God will restore everything you've lost. But some of the information I got was that there were almost 250 police officers, SSS, civil defense. They used all these security agencies because of a demolition of a house. When there's crime going on, when there's people burning each other in Sokoto, they had all these security agencies. Am I correct? 200.
You are very, very correct. If not more than that, you are very, very correct.
That's a war. That's like a war.
Oh my, I need to bring some people in. Make a request if you want. Oh, you have a lot of requests, Prince. There's like 18 people. There's so many questions, we're going to answer all of it. No court order, and they're saying it's an order from above. Is that what they said? Order from above.
That is what the man said.
He said he's another from up.
How are you doing mentally? It's mental health.
I'm fine. I'm a very strong man.
Are you staying with family or you're in a hotel somewhere?
I'm in a hotel. I have to be in a hotel, but I'm negotiating to get a place for my people. I think by tomorrow I'll sort that out.
The government should be paying for your hotel. This is mismanagement. And you know, the media has been silent about this. A lot of the media are silent. Have you noticed that?
Of course. I noticed.
The media is silent, but if it was, say, governor or some other big person's house that they demolished, it'd be in the front paper. Everybody has been quiet. I watched this story from Saturday till today, Tuesday, and I said nobody has really done this story. It should be a 24-hour story. When I heard how the house girl was almost trapped in there, okay? No pasted poster, no court order, no nothing. No nothing, no apology. Impunity, injustice, okay?
I got a demolition notice that is not my